Welcome to my YouTube channel Medical Knowledge, where medicine makes sense. In this video, I will discuss about the common foot condition plantar fasciitis. Plantar fascia is a thick connective aponeurosis that originates proximally on the middle tubercle of calcaneus and inserts distally in the form of five distinct bands onto the metatarsal head and the bases of proximal phalanges. Plantar fasciitis is a condition caused by inflammation of the aponeurosis at its origin on the calcaneus. It affects the posterior medial heel. The risk factor for plantar fasciitis include obesity, decreased ankle dorsiflexion in a non-athletic population due to tightness of foot and calf musculature, like by wearing a high heel. Jobs that include weight bearing and endurance activities like dancing and running. The chronic overuse leads to micro tear in the origin of plantar fascia, and the repetitive trauma leads to recurrent inflammation and periosteitis. A classical finding in a patient with plantar fasciitis is insidious onset of heel pain, often when first getting out of bed, relieved by ambulation. A patient may prefer to walk on toes initially. Pain is described as a sharp heel pain. The pain gets worse at the end of day after prolonged standing or other activities. It is common to have symptoms bilaterally, and both males and females are equally affected. This video is made possible by the help of Dr.Sriram Khati, MS Orthopedics, Jipmer. We try our best to provide you with precise and comprehensive information based on current evidences on common medical condition. So if you like to see more videos like this in future, please do subscribe to our channel. The tenderness may be present on palpation at medial tuberosity of calcaneus. The dorsiflexion of the toe and foot increases tenderness. There is a limited ankle dorsiflexion due to tight Achilles tendon. Diagnosis of plantar fasciitis is primarily a clinical one. Radiographs are not necessary on initial visit, but when done, they often come normal, or may show plantar heel spur on lateral X-ray. The plantar heel spur is not a cause of pain, whereas this spur may have developed due to plantar fasciitis. Operating on spur does not alleviate the pain. The first line of treatment is non-operative, which includes conservative treatment like taking rest, using sew in sole, pain control by use of ice pack and painkiller. Dorsiflexion night splints can be used for chronic plantar fasciitis. Physiotherapy is the mainstay of treatment and includes plantar fascia stretching and strengthening exercise. Two such exercises will be demonstrated here. First, for the first exercise, we need an ice cold water bottle. After getting it, place the bottle underneath your foot. Touch the heel with toes pointing upward in ankle dorsiflexion position. Remain in this position for 10 seconds. Then slowly roll the foot towards the toe. Firmly held your toes against the bottle and remain in this position for another 10 seconds. This procedure is done 3 times a day and a session lasting for 10 minutes. For the second exercise, we need a towel. Place your foot on the towel. Slowly grab the towel by your toes and hold it firmly. Don't lift your toes up in the air while doing so, and you should notice the arc of your foot held up while doing this. Hold this position for 10 seconds. After 10 seconds, ease down your toes for 4 to 5 seconds. This procedure should be repeated 30 times in a session. 3 such sessions should be done in a day. The severe nature of heel pain in plantar fasciitis may prompt you to use corticosteroid injection, but evidence has shown that uses of corticosteroid injections can lead to fat pad atrophy or plantar fascia rupture. Plantar fascia rupture due to this steroid injection may lead to more pain, so uses of steroid injections should be discouraged. If the heel pain lasts longer than 6 months, when other treatments have failed but the pain is still there, shockwave therapy can be used as a second line of treatment. it is less likely a patient of plantar fasciitis need a operative management. But some operations used for alleviating pain of plantar fasciitis are, there is no clear indication established on the use of gastrocnemius recession operation for plantar fasciitis. If the pain is persistent for 9 months and all other conservative treatment have failed, surgical release with plantar fasciotomy can be done. In the presence of concomitant compression neuropathy, tibial nerve in tarsal tunnel, surgical release with plantar fasciotomy and distal tarsal tunnel decompression can be done. Thank you for watching this video. If you like the content of this video and want to learn more, please do subscribe to this channel.